pregnant for the first time, I would look down at my large belly and swelling breasts that had gone from a modest B cup to a generous D cup, thank you, hormones, seemingly overnight, and wonder how these two things would provide nourishment to a tiny, helpless baby for the first year of his life. I will embarrassingly admit to squeezing my nipples in the shower in those last few weeks of my pregnancy, trying to see if anything would come out. It didn't. The moment my son was born was unforgettable. He was perfect. He was mine. The nurse immediately put him on my chest, and this primal, animalistic feeling came over me. I felt the urgency to feed him right away. He latched on gently, suckling away. I'll never forget that feeling. I called my best friend back home in tears because everything hurt. She laid it out for me. Sam, the first month is gonna suck. I'm not gonna lie. But if you're committed to this, then stick it out. And in a few weeks, you guys will both get the hang of it and you will love it, truly. The next few weeks were a blur of letdowns, leaks, learning to pump, feeding schedules, sleepless nights, and blocked milk ducts. Microwaving a wet diaper is a savior. A few weeks later, my son and I were cuddled in his quiet nursery as the sun was setting, and I had a moment of pure joy. He was staring up at me with adoration, or gas, and he smiled. His little hands were wrapped around mine, and my eyes welled up and tears spilled onto his perfectly smooth cheeks. This was what my friend had told me about. This was that moment. And then it all changed again. Just as my son and I were getting in our groove with breastfeeding and he started to put on weight, colic began. We tried everything. Finally, his pediatrician sent us to a specialist who suggested I cut out dairy, caffeine, soy, and basically every enjoyable food group. Well, that did the trick. My breast milk had been causing my baby pain. Cue the mom guilt. And cut to the freezer filled with 6 months worth of breast milk I had labored over, all useless to my child now. Yeah, I ended up donating my liquid gold to a surrogate family in need. All 40 ounces of it. Ouch. I kept on breastfeeding because Ryder only wanted me and my boobs. He never took a bottle, like, ever. And I was happy to oblige. He would take forever at each feeding, so cuddly and sweet, always staring into my eyes and caressing me with those little hands. This relationship with my son was so intimate and dear to me that I couldn't imagine anything different. When my husband and I decided we wanted to try to get pregnant again, Ryder was 15 months old, and I knew it was the right time to wean him. I, however, was a mess. That last night, we cuddled together when I knew it was going to be the last time we would be doing this way. I was proud of my boy growing up and moving forward to new things. I was excited for the newfound freedom, but I was heartbroken to end this part of our relationship that I'd worked so hard for and that it turned out to be so wonderful. And I had no idea what hit me in those days following my last feeding with my son. My breasts turned into rocks. Like, literally. My hair started to fall out, and my skin lost that dewy glow, and I cried, like, all the time. And then one morning, as if someone had stuck a pin in and deflated them, my size D breasts had gone back to size B, only sadder and different. I got pregnant a month later, and the first thought that popped into my head was, yes, I get another go at this whole breastfeeding thing. Seriously. My second son, Asher, was born a pound bigger, chunky, and like a little cherub. He latched on right away, as if he knew exactly what he was supposed to do. He ate quickly, and he ate a lot, and I produced a ton of milk. I started pumping right away, this time avoiding any of the same food culprits. Asher was quick and to the point. He didn't linger at my breast the way his brother had. He didn't look into my eyes or fall asleep in my arms. It was all business. When Asher was 3 months old, I got a job at a trendy millennial magazine, and needless to say, this changed everything. I pumped everywhere. I'm pretty convinced that most of LA has seen my boobs, and I'm totally okay with that. It all worked. Asher went from boob to bottle seamlessly. He seemed to be the kind of kid that, as long as it was food, he was cool with it. I didn't know if he'd be my last baby, and I was committed to breastfeeding him as long as he wanted me to. I never wanted it to end. On a trip home from Canada, flying with my mom and my two boys, I became violently ill. I continued to breastfeed and pump dutifully through it. On day 5, I went to the hospital. They admitted me because I was so dehydrated. I was torn away from my baby, and I was his food source. Yes, we had a few ounces of breast milk stored, but not enough to get through the next few days. I instructed my mom to buy formula, not sure which kind, and told her to mix it with breast milk to ease him into it. I begged the nurses to find me a pump at the hospital so I could keep up my supply for him and for me. They looked at me like I was insane. I mean, here I was, in the hospital, not concerned with my own well-being and overcome with guilt and shame about not being able to feed my son. 3 days later, when I got home, Asher was happy to get back to breastfeeding, but there wasn't much there. I did everything I could to build my supply back up, but at 10 months, that wasn't an easy feat, and I knew the time was coming to say goodbye to this relationship with this son, but I wasn't ready. We went back and forth from breast to formula the following weeks, and it was almost as if he was kind of appeasing me. One morning, I presented my breast to him, and he looked me right in the eyes, and he pushed it away with his hands and said very clearly, "No." And that was it. I went through the same process as I had 1.5 years ago, well prepared this time and with more perspective. It wasn't the end of anything, but the beginning of so many exciting things yet to come. I'm always going to cherish those nights cuddled together in their rocking chairs. Nothing in the whole world but me, them,